Hello and welcome to Pardrift. Today we are talking about a motorcycle that has just gone on sale in India, the Harley Davidson Pan America. The Pan America is a little bit because Harley Davidson have done a lot of work and it's very, very different from your normal average Harley Davidson today. First of all, it's an adventure tourer. Harley Davidson didn't just take an existing platform and put additional suspension on it and try to create a motorcycle out of it. So everything on the motorcycle is brand new. The one thing that we'll talk about the least and at the end is the styling. So let's begin with the new engine, which Harley Davidson calls Revolution Max. It's a 1250cc engine, which is roughly where the big ADVs are at. So whether you take the Multistrada, which is a 1260, you take the GS today, which is also a 1250, this is a 1252cc engine. It is still a V-twin. And again, there are lots of V-twins in this segment as well. And Harley Davidson this time have chosen a 60-degree V-twin to do the job for them. Now, 60 is not a traditional number for Harley Davidson. If you know what that number is, leave us a comment. Now this V-twin is a completely modern V-twin in every sense of the word. So you've got the 60 degree V-twin, you've got liquid cooling, you've got fuel injection, you've got DOHC, you've got 4 valves per cylinder, so it's an 8 valve engine in total. But get this, Harley Davidson didn't stop there either. They thought that an adventure tourer would do well if for off-roading there was a lot of torque at the bottom, which of course Harley Davidson does quite well. And for cruising, especially two up with luggage, if it had a lot more power on top as well. So to blend both the characters together, they have actually created a completely new full range variable valve timing system. So the peak torque, it's 128 Newton meters. 128, to give you a reference, is a little bit less than the GS. It's actually a little bit more than the Multistrada V4. But what Harley Davidson says is the torque curve is really flat. So the peak, which is just under 7,000 RPM, is not really a peak as much as the highest point on what looks more or less like a plateau. And for the first time, Harley Davidson is actually doing something that I don't think they've ever done in the history before. They're actually claiming a horsepower figure. Yeah, I know. Mind blown, right? So the Revolution Max makes 150 PS, and that is again where the ballpark of these kind of machines today at the upper end is. The exceptions being stuff like the Multistrada V4, which of course makes about, I think, 20 bhp more, whereas the GS makes about 15 or 16 bhp less. But 150 PS is a lot of power and a lot of usable power for a machine like this, especially what Harley Davidson is promising is correct, which is a lot of torque off the bottom that blends smoothly into a lot of power on top. Matched to this engine is a 6-speed gearbox. There is a slip and assist clutch. So Harley Davidson has left no stone unturned to ensure that this is a thoroughly modern, extremely normal engine with good performance parameters. Does this translate to the street? That is a question I have to answer at the first ride. But they didn't stop there either, because the frame is brand new as well. And again, it's a very unusual construction for Harley Davidson to use, because the engine is the heart of the frame. They have a steel tube structure, a trellis, to which the front, the headstock, the suspension, all of that is mounted. They have a steel subframe on which you will sit and your passenger will sit and the luggage will go. And of course, the swing arm also mounts to the mid frame, which is forged aluminium. This technique is not unknown. If you think about it, the Panigale V4 is similar, except that it doesn't have the steel tube in the front anymore. It uses an aluminium cast section for that as well. Now, an ADV does require big suspension, right? So the Harley Davidson will give you almost 190 millimeters of travel at both of its ends. And there's two models, the base and the special. The special, of course, gets semi-active suspension from Showa with calibration and software done by Harley Davidson. That's about 2 lakh rupees more. But the base model already has fully adjustable suspension at front and rear, and 190 mm of travel is not to be scoffed at, especially when combined with 210 mm of ground clearance, where the highest numbers in the segment more or less sit. Now, generally in the ADV class, the more road-oriented the bike is, the ground clearance numbers fall a little bit. The more seriously the manufacturer takes off-roading, that number climbs up a little bit. And the penalty of ground clearance, of course, is seat height. And the Harley Davidson has 870, which is a little bit on the high side. But again, remember, Harley does a very nice product and accessory catalog that tackles things like this. So expect to find things like bar risers to raise the handlebar if you're a tall rider, as well as a lower seat option. You've got Brembo monoblocks on 320mm front disc, a 280mm at the back. You've got ABS, and this time the Pan America also has an IMU, which means you not only get traction control, cornering, ABS and ABS, you get 5 riding modes, you get controllability over the riding modes, and a lot of other fancy features, which again are not something you normally associate with Harley Davidson. So, like I keep coming back to, the Pan America is a very, very unusual kind of motorcycle for Harley to make, and therefore they've left no stone unturned to really, really try to blow your mind, at least at the spec level, and we have to see how it translates to the world. Now, the Americans, the Europeans who've had a chance to ride the Pan America have all said the answer to the question, did Harley Davidson build a really nice adventure tourer, is a resounding yes. They really have done their homework and they've done a really nice job of it. I'm hoping that when it comes to India, it fits into our world just as easily and we get another great option for people who love ADVs. But let's get back to the Pan America, because we still have to talk about the feature set, which includes a 6.8 inch TFT color screen, which Harley Davidson says you can operate with gloves. In there is baked in Bluetooth, there is a map navigation, which means once you sync your phone and use the correct app, the map will take over the screen and you'll be able to see navigation without having to mount the phone as a second screen. And all of that is wrapped up in, I have to say, is fairly unique styling. But there is a trick to it. If you take the picture of the Pan America and just hide the front of it, the front fairing of the motorcycle, you'll realize that it is actually a pretty normal looking motorcycle, and the exposed steel trellis at the back actually looks quite nice. But it's that square boxy front fairing that has really, really caused a lot of controversy, because there are people who absolutely love it and who think it looks like an industrial military style machine, like a tank, and there's others who like, not sure what Harley Davidson did there. Now, Harley Davidson has done these bar kind of headlamps before. Just look at the current generation of the Fat Bob. But on the Pan America, it does look very, very striking and very, very unique. I'm not a fan of what this motorcycle looks like from the pictures. It's not a traditionally good looking motorcycle. I'm going to wait to see the motorcycle to decide whether it's a good looking motorcycle to me or not. But that's the story of the Pan America, which Harley Davidson hopes will bring new customers to the showroom and show them a new side of Harley Davidson. And if it becomes popular, Harley Davidson's incentive to develop more motorcycles that talk to other segments outside of the traditional cruiser format will be larger. Do you think this is a good idea for Harley Davidson, and do you think the Pan America will be an interesting option for people who would normally end up with something like a BMW GS or a Ducati Multistrada or a Honda Africa Twin? Leave us a comment. What else would you like us to talk about specifically when we actually get to ride the Pan America? Do leave us a comment as well. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Shumi. This is Pardrift. We are in Maharashtra today under lockdown, and we are taking every precaution we can and not going out at all. And I highly recommend that if you can avoid going out, please do. And if you have to go out, do mask up, and please take care of yourself. The news is frightening and we don't want to be part of the problem. Thank you so much for watching.